Good morning students, today we are going to discuss on activity number 4 in Excel. We have already seen about activity number 3, now we are going to embark on activity number 4. The activity number 4 has the main idea is you will learn how to use the statistical functions in Excel. That's the first thing that you will use in this particular activity, you will try to learn. And then the next one is you will also learn sorting and filtering in Excel. So these are the two main ideas that we are going to focus in this particular activity. So you can see that the first one is open the file business Excel activity 4. See, I have opened the file. Now the file is book 1, but there I have given the file name should be what? It should be save as, and I want to save it in desktop. You can see the file name, I want to give it as business 106 excel activity number 4 or activity 4. So I have tried to now save the file. So now you can see that the file is now saved as, before it was book 1, now it has saved as business 106 excel activity number 4. So now you have done the first part. You can see here, now you can see here we have done this part. So this is clear for you. It is a simple activity, opening the file and saving the file as business Excel activity number 4. Now we are going to copy. See, now we have saved the file. You can see that we have saved the file also. So we have opened the file and then we have actually saved the file also, and now this file is actually called activity number 4. So we have opened the file and we have named the file or saved the file. Now we are going to, you also know this one, how to save the file. So these two questions are very clear. Now it's not add the rows, add the data. You see here, this is the data we are going to type. As I already told you, in a regular class I will expect you to type and come. Since this is an online class, I don't want to waste a lot of time in typing the information. So what I will do is that I will try to copy this information. So when I want to copy the information, first of all, it's a PDF file. So I am going to open the file from an Excel. So the Excel actually in the Word, sorry, not Excel, it's Word file. Because you see, I have given you the Word document already, where we have all the activities in sequence. Now we are in activity number 4. So this is the data which I am going to copy. So what I do is that I will click on this table, right click on this table, I will copy. I repeat again, because since it's a PDF file, it's not easy to copy. So I right click, I copy now. Now after copying, I am going to open the Excel file again, which I have it here ready, empty file, but it is named as business 104 activity. So I am going to paste the cells. Can you see now here, when I paste the cell, the cells have come exactly in the same way with the colors and everything. But if you are going to use this one, you see, this is how it will look like when you are going to type it. Since you know how to put the colors and other things, I am using the first one. I am using the source formatting. I am copying as such the color, the borders, the merge and center. I am not going to repeat it again because already we have seen all these things in the previous activities. So in a normal setting, when you type, it will look like this. Then you have to put the border, you have to make merge and center, you have to use wrap text wherever it is required, you have to also add the colors, all these things you will do. But now, since we are going to finish the video in a short way, I am actually going to use the keep source formatting. But maybe for you, I am not going to give you the Word file, I am going to give you the PDF file. That means you need to type this data. Since the class is an online class, I am actually not going to waste a lot of time in typing the data. Now if you look at this one, there are few things that I have to adjust still. You can see here, the count, the standard deviation one was not clear, so I make it little bit bigger by dragging the column, and now we have all the data in front of me ready. But now you see, this is the answer. I don't want to actually have these answers now. I want to delete these answers. But you can see that these are the answers which are expected. 73.650, 75.5, 12.829, and all these things are here now. But anyway, I will delete all these things now because I want to go step by step with you to make it clear for you to understand. Now you see here, you have typed the information as it is given here. So I think this part is also clear for you. Now we have done question number 1, question number 2 and 3. Let us go to the question number 4. So what is there in the question number 4? I will just let you know. See here, calculate the mean for, now we are going to find calculations. How many calculations are there? In total, there are 10 calculations we are going to make. So we have the file. Calculate the mean. That's the first one. I am just highlighting it for you to see. You can see here, this is mean. We are going to calculate the mean for business 101. Okay. Basically, we are going to calculate everything for business 101. Then we are going to calculate the mode for business 101. And then we are also going to calculate the median for business 101. See, median we are going to calculate for business 101. Okay. And also we are going to calculate the standard deviation. Okay. For business 101. We are going to calculate the standard deviation for business 101. Standard deviation we are going to calculate. We are also going to calculate the maximum for business 101. So let us answer these 5 questions. So my primary goal is to calculate 5 things for business 101. Number 1, mean. Number 2, mode. Number 3, median. Number 4, standard deviation. Number 5, maximum. These are the 5 things which I want to calculate. So when I want to calculate this 5, what I am going to do is that I am actually going to open the Excel sheet. Now mean is what? It's actually average. So you can use the function or you can use the formula equal to average. When you type average, the formula comes. You can see what is the function that is also given here. Returns the arithmetic mean. Can you see here? Mean, arithmetic mean of the values for which you are going to find the average. Average means what? It is going to give you the arithmetic mean of the values which you are going to calculate. Now we are going to calculate the mean for the students who have taken business 101. How many students are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 students are there. So I am going to select from Abdullah. Not Abdullah, I am going to select the mark of Abdullah. From Abdullah, I am going to select up to Tafood. Can you see now? Now I am calculating the arithmetic mean for the students who have taken business 101 class. So if you look at this one, now I have given, first started with a equal to, then I type average, then I open a bracket, I selected the cells for which I want to find the average, which is nothing but arithmetic mean. So this is from C4. Can you see here? This is C4. It goes up to C15. Now I open the I close the bracket. Now the formula is ready. I press enter. Now the answer, the mean of the students, the 12 students, average of the 2 students, or you call in Arabic sometimes muaddal of the students, is 73.6. Now I am going to calculate mode. So to calculate the mode, I am also going to use the formula. Very simple. MOD. MOD. Can you see here? MOD. Mode. 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 What is mode? You can see here. If you want to know the mode, you can see here. Okay. Returns most frequently occurring or repetitive value in a range or data. It is going to give us which value in these numbers, which marks of this 12 students is appearing very often. It is repetitive. So this is what is going to give, the mode is going to give us. So equal to mode, always all the formulas start with equal to, then type the function name. Even you can use sum in the same way, you can use maximum, everything you can use. Okay. Now you have the mode, and then what you do is that you select the cell from all the marks for the 12 students. Starting from Abdullah, you go until Tafood. That means what? Mode C4 to C15. I am finding the mode for C4 to C15. That means I am trying to find out which number is repeated most often in this range of 12 students. So then the formula is ready. I press enter. Now 50. So why 50? You can see here two students have got 50 marks. There are no other students like 50 is repeated most. It's occurring more. So more is 50. So now let us calculate the next one. The next one is we are going to find out the next one about median. So how to calculate the median is equal to median. You type the function. The function name is median. F of x means what? Function name. Then whenever you type equal to, then type the function name, then open a bracket. When you open a bracket, you see that before the bracket, I want you to know what is this median. It returns the number in the middle. It's not going to give the mean average. It is going to give you the middle number in the total marks, which is the middle number. Which mark is in the middle of the range? That's going to be given by median. So equal to median, then you will open a bracket, then you will select the cell from business 101 for all the marks of the 12 students here. Can you see it here? So median equal to C4 to C15. So it is going to return for me what? The value which is going to be the middle mark, which is the middle range, which is the middle number in this range of mark. The middle range for this mark is what? If I divide it into half, it is 75.5. The middle mark is 75.5. Now I am going to go to the next one. It is to calculate the standard deviation. So to calculate the standard deviation for all the 12 students, what I have to do is that I will type equal to standard deviation. Can you see here? STDEV, standard deviation. There are many variants of the standard deviation, but I am going to use this standard deviation. Okay, it estimates the standard deviation. That means what? It will try to find out the difference between each of the values in the range, the difference or the gap between the ranges. Now if you are going to see here, I am selecting these ranges, the marks. This is the array of marks. Array means what? A group of marks which we have, starting from C4 until C15. So it is called what? Standard deviation, STDEV, standard deviation. Then what I do is that I am actually closing the bracket. So now I press enter. So the average or the gap between the numbers is 12.82. For example, the standard deviation is expected to be less. That means the difference of mark between the two students should not be more in a group of students. So here it is 12.8. Now I am going to calculate the maximum. How to calculate the maximum? You know very well. It is also equal. I use the formula and I am writing the function max. Max returns the largest value. You know very well maximum means which is going to give the largest value. I open the bracket. Then I am selecting the range of cells, starting from C4 up to C15. Then I close the bracket. So can you see now? See, this is actually indicating to me that these cells are going to be included in my calculation. Max of C4 to C15. I press enter. The maximum mark is 91, which you can see here, which is of Sabha. Now I have calculated all these things. Now let us go to the exercise or the activity to see what is the next question. Calculate the count of grade more than 90. I want to calculate the number of students who got more than 90 in business 101. That's my first target. The next target is to find out who have got grade less than 90. First, I want to find out the students who have got 90. How many? Not who are. How many students got more than 90? How many students got less than 80? And I also want to find out how many students got grade equal to 80 in the course business 101. So this is my aim. So 6, 7, 8 is very simple. I am going to use a function called COUNTIF. I am going to use a function called COUNTIF. So I am just going to show you for your easy understanding here. I am going to use a function called COUNTIF. So for this 3, I am going to use a function called COUNTIF. So COUNTIF. I will use the COUNTIF function for these 3 questions, which is here. You can see question number 6, question number 6, question number 7, question number 8. I am going to use this for these 3 questions, a function which is called COUNTIF. And also you should know, for this one, I have already explained to you, I used maximum max function. The function which I used is what? Max function. And for this function, for this question, I used STDDEV, standard deviation function. I used standard deviation function. And for this one, I used median function. And for this one, which is mode, I used MODE, mode function I used. And also for the first one, I used average. If you can see here, for this one, I used average function. Average function, because it is nothing but the arithmetic mean of the range of numbers. So you can see I am just putting it here for you to know. So question number 6, 7, 8 are going to use only the same function, which is nothing but, you can see here, this is going to use 6 also, 7 also use the same function, and also you can see that 8 will use the same function, which is nothing but, we are going to use the function like which I told you just now. We are going to use the COUNTIF function. So I am going to explain to you. 6, 7, 8 will be understood to you by now by completing this one. Question number 6 is to find out the mark of the student who, number of students who have got more than 90 in business 101. The second question is to find out the students who have got less than 90 in business 101. And the 8th question is to find out the students who got mark or grade equal to 80. So now let us try to do the question in Excel. I go back to Excel sheet, which I already opened for you here. Now I am going to answer this question. See, I have also given here COUNTIF function, because you can easily understand. Now here what I do is that I just use the formula equal COUNT. Already we used COUNT before in the previous activity. Now you are using COUNTIF. Now you open a bracket in COUNTIF. You see there are 2 things. One is range. What is range? What are the cells you are going to include in your calculation? There is another one which is called criteria. What is the criteria? Condition. What is the condition that you are going to check here? Grade more than 90. That's your condition. So let us first do the first part, the range. So the range of cell that you are going to use is what? From C4 to C15. And then you can see that there is a comma which you have to give. And what is the criteria? The criteria is, you have to give the criteria like this. Shift, okay, double quotes, greater than 90. And then, okay, see, if there is any problem, it will actually tell you there is a problem. Okay, so you can just give yes, correct it. Now you can see here, is there any student who got more than 90? According to this, it is giving 0. Why it is giving 0? Because the quote is, now can you see here, it is empty. So I just put here grade greater than 90. Now I just press enter, I get 1. I show the formula again. See, what was the mistake before? Before, you see that I put like this. When I type very quickly, I did not notice that I typed outside here, greater than 90, outside the quote. That's why the answer did not come, as it came as 0. But you should type between double quotes. You have to type the condition within double quotes, 2 double quotes. Now you have to type greater, because what is the condition? Greater than 90. So I want to know I want to know how many students have got more than 90 marks. Only one student has got more than 90 marks, which is Sabha. Can you see here? Sabha. Now, I want to find out. See, there is a difference here. If you look at the question here, what is the question? Grade less than 90. But in the table, I have given it as what? Grade less than 60. So, if you want, you can just change it as 90. No problem. As in the question. As in the question. Grade less than 90. Now, what I do is that, again, I am going to type the equation equal. Then I type count if. I open the bracket. Once I open the bracket, I select the range of cells. I select the range of cells. This is from C4 to C15. The cells which I am going to use in my calculation is C4 to C15. Then what I do is that I have to type a comma as in the syntax. Can you see now? This is the range. What is the range? The range is C4 to C15. Okay. Now I am going to type the condition, criteria. What is criteria? The criteria is the condition for which I am going to find the numbers. Count equal, not equal, double quotes. Then I type less than 90, because that is the condition which I am going to find out. How many people are less than 90? Close the double quotes, then close the bracket. Can you see now? Count if, then select the range from C4 to C15, put a comma, then write the condition less than 90. Put the condition within the double quotes. You have to enclose between the two double quotes. That's very important. Now press enter. There are 11 students who have got grades less than 90. This is very natural. Only one student has got more than 90. The remaining rest, 11 out of the 12 students, have got less than 90 marks. Now let us go to the next one. Here I have a condition where I am going to check the grade is equal to 80. How to do this? It is also very simple. Equal to, again you are going to type the formula count if. I am going to type the formula count if. I will open the bracket. After I open the bracket, I will select the cells starting from here. Can you see here? From C4 to C15. This is range. Already from Abdullah up to Taful, I want to calculate the students who got mark which is equal to 80. So again I give the comma as usual, and I am giving a double quote for the condition, and I am typing the condition equal 80. I am typing equal to 80, and I am using a, I am closing the double quote, and then I am closing a bracket. See it here. Count if. What is my range of cell? From C4 to C15. I am going to select from C4 to C15, which is nothing but the mark of Abdullah. There are two Abdullahs. So it's quite common that name Abdullah is very common in the Arab world. So Abdullah and Abdullah, like this, there are two Abdullah. So now you see here, count if from C4 to C15, and the condition is 80. So now I press equal to. There is only one student who has got 80. Let us check. Yes, this is Taful who has got 80 marks. So now we have calculated all these things. Now let us go here. Now you are done up to question number 8. So I hope you know now, number 1, I think by this time, I think you should be knowing now how to do these things. Number 1, I think you should know, you will be knowing the question number, you should be knowing the question number 1, I think. Now I think you are ready with this one. You are ready with the question number 2. You are ready with the question number 3. You are ready with the question number 4. Also, you are ready with the question number 5, 6. Yes, you are ready. And 7 and 8, you are ready. Okay. Okay, I put double tick for 7, so don't think it is double tick. It's okay, it's only one tick. Now we are going to answer question number 9. Repeat the above calculation for business 102. Repeat the above calculation for business 102. Now I am going to calculate the same thing for business 102. So how to do this one? Again, I am opening the Excel file. So now you can see here, just you can see I am going to copy this file from here to here. For business 102 also, there is only one student who has got more than 90. Is it true? It is not true. Greater than 90. Is there any student who is more than 90? Yes. Ahmed has got more than 90. Only one student. You can see here, Ahmed has got only one student who has got more than 90 in business 102. So I am going to copy the same formula. You can see here, I keep the pointer here. From the plus, it becomes thin plus. Then I drag it. 11 students have got less than 90. It is very obvious. I want to check if anybody has got 80 marks. Only one student has got 80, and that is Nader. You can see here, the Nader has got 80 marks in business 102. Now let me read the next question in the activity. So now you are ready for this question also. You are ready with this one. So now let us go to the next question. The next question that we are going to have is what? Copy the formulas for mean. We are going to calculate the formula for mean. You can see here, mean, mode, median. From mean, mode, median, standard deviation and COUNTIF. For business 103, we are going to do it for business 103, sorry, business 103, 104, 105 and 106. Business 106 is our course. So calculate mean, mode, median, standard deviation and COUNTIF for business 103, 104, 105 and 106. Now again I am going to open the Excel file. See, I am going to do the things very easily. Now I am going to see that the pointer, which is white plus, becomes thin black plus. I am going to drag it here for all the courses 102, 103, 104, 105 and 106. Now I calculated the mean. No need to calculate again and again. Just you can drag and it will be copied. Can you see now here? It is copied. The mode is copied. Again I repeat, the pointer, which is white plus, when you take it over here, it becomes thin black plus. Once it becomes thin black plus, just extend it in this way. Then you can see here, I am going to calculate the standard deviation in this way, like this. It is also done. Now I am going to do the same thing for maximum. Again, please note down, the pointer is white plus in color. When I am going to take it here, it becomes black and thin in plus. Now I am going to drag it holding the left mouse button. Holding the left mouse button. Now you can see here, it is like the maximum is calculated. Now I am going to calculate the COUNTIF function where the student, how many students have got more than 90 in business 103, 4, 5 and 6. So this is the situation. Nobody got more than 90 in business 103. 3 got in business 104. 1 got in business 105. And 1 got in business 106. Now let us go to the next one. Again, the same way, we are going to drag it holding the left mouse button. This is the answer. And now I am going to repeat the same thing here by just dragging it over here. And you can see that nobody got 80 in business 103, 104, 105 and 106. There is no one who got exactly 80 marks. So you can use it for COUNTIF. You can use it for greater, less than, greater or equal to, less than or equal to and equal to. So this is what is the idea of using the COUNTIF function. Now the last part of this activity is what? Save the file. I want to now save the file. It is very simple. I want to save the file means what? I have to save the file. How to save the file? Already we have saved the file in the beginning. So how to save the file is very simple. You go here, just click this icon, save. See, you may think about this icon. What is this icon? In the original history of the computers, we used floppy disk. This is actually the icon of a floppy. Floppy was the original device where we stored data. So that's why still this icon is still used. Because even though now you may not have seen the floppy at all. Maybe when I say floppy, you say, what is floppy? Because you have not seen the floppy. But this was the original device which was used for saving in the beginning. So still they are using the same icon. So click on this one, the file will be saved. See, I would like to tell you one important thing, as I always told you before also. Whenever you are working with programs like Excel or any computer related programs, please keep on saving your work every 5 minutes. First, you save the file with a name. Then you start working on it. Then keep on pressing this icon every 5 minutes, every 5 minutes, so that even though anything happens, the computer gets stuck, or if there is a problem with the electricity and your computer gets switched off, still you will not lose your work. You can be able to get back your work. So please make it as a habit. It is going to yield a lot of benefits for you. Again, I would like to tell you again one more time, the course is practical course. It has a good opportunity to score marks. So what is needed from you is you have to practice. Once you start practicing a lot, it becomes just like drinking water. Do you find any difficulty in drinking water? The same is with this course. That's what I would like to tell you. And with this note, I would like to end my class for today. See you in the next class, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.